Welcome to the One Minute Apologists. We interview the world's leading apologists to provide credible answers to curious questions.
Jonathan, there's a massive debate going on in scholarship today amongst who are the authors of the Gospels. In your opinion, who wrote the Gospels?
Well, the traditional view, of course, is that the authors are Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. That has come under immense fire today from the likes of Bart Ehrman, the Chapel Hill, North Carolina scholar, textual scholar, who's written a number of books against Christianity. And I would argue that you can actually make a good case for the traditional authorship of the Gospels. For example, it's curious that the Gospel of Mark and Luke are attributed to those individuals because they're pretty minor characters. I mean, neither Mark nor Luke were disciples of Jesus. Mark is best known for having abandoned Paul in Pamphylia and causing the split between Paul and Barnabas. Luke was connected with eyewitnesses, but he wasn't an eyewitness himself. And Matthew was, of course, a tax collector, and they were seen by the Jews as being traitors. Whereas if you read the Gnostic Gospels, these apocryphal forgeries, they uniformly attribute those documents to high-profile characters like Peter and Thomas and James and so forth. Moreover, you find this wide geographical spread of attestation in the late 2nd century from Clement of Alexandria, from Tertullian of Carthage, from Irenaeus of Lyon, from Papias of Hierapolis, and these have a large geographical spread which suggests that the traditions go back to an earlier tradition and a very monolithic tradition because of the unanimity of the traditions. Moreover, in the early 2nd century, you have these Gospels being quoted without names attached to them. Now that's interesting because the Old Testament scriptures are also often cited without names being attached to them, which suggests that the author actually understands their audience to understand these books to be authoritative. And if there was controversy and debate about the authorship of these Gospels, you would expect that to be reflected when finally names were attached to these documents. We also know from Justin Martyr, for example, refers to the memoirs of Peter. And the memoirs of Peter, he says, contain the account where the sons of Zebedee, James and John, are renamed the Boanerges, or the sons of thunder. And he also tells us about the renaming of Simon as Peter. Now those don't occur, neither of those occur in the extant copy we have of the so-called Gospel of Peter, but both are in the Gospel of Mark, and the Sons of Thunder incident's only in Mark, which suggests that this is actually the Gospel of Mark. And you would wonder, one wants to wonder, if they were so sure, because other people tell us this as well, Irenaeus and so on, that Mark's Gospel was influenced by Peter. Papias of Hierapolis tells us this as well. Why not call it the Gospel of Peter? Why go with the Gospel of Mark? It suggests that they had a restraint, that they felt themselves restrained by who actually did write the Gospels, who was the traditional authors, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John.